Namaste to everyone. Today in this video, we will be taking you to an amazing, never before seen like tiger land located in Vindhya Mountains in northern Madhya Pradesh in India. We visited this beautiful tiger sanctuary in 2016. In this video, we will be sharing some glimpses of this amazing forest. We went in the month of November, immediately after the end of the monsoon seasons, when the park opens again. It's a dry deciduous forest characterized by extensive plateaus and gorges, amazing flora and fauna. It's a land of mesmerizing waterfalls, various archaeological splendors, not very far away from Khajuraho. It's a land of legends and cultural richness. This is located in the northern part of the Indian state of Madhya Pradesh in the northern India. This is River Ken, which flows across the Tiger Reserve, the Panna National Park. The whole park has a topography which varies from plateaus to gorges to beautiful dry grasslands, thick forests, vegetation. It's an amazing place, simply amazing, mind-blowing it was. In monsoons, all these gorges convert into beautiful waterfalls. The gypsy drives inside the park are the best way to explore the wide diversity of flora and fauna. Though we keep tracking tigers most of the time when we are inside a tiger national park, but apart from it, the whole landscape, if we can just stroll in the designated areas where walking is a bit allowed, here you can see what an amazing landscape. The yellow color grass in the backdrop was Vindhyachal Mountains. Athar was walking along with me here. In the early morning, we started our day. It was pitch dark when we started our journey to the national park in an open jeep safari. It was very cold in the morning. It was early winters, but still it was very cold, a bit foggy also. We are crossing River Ken right now. Here we covered ourselves with towels, actually from the hotels, to protect us from the chilly wind of the morning. These jungles have very rich, mainly the trees that are here are sal and the teak trees. The dominating vegetation type is dry deciduous forest and interspread with grassland areas. Other major forest types that are here are riverines, open grasslands, open woodlands with tall grasses and thorny woodlands also. The colors of the grasses were amazing, and in the morning in the sunlight, the yellow color, the golden grass color, it was all very mesmerizing. Slowly as the sun came out, there was a bit of warmth in the air. The smell in the air of the vegetation is something which is very, very difficult to forget. The whole environment was heavenly. We kept on driving in the muddy paths, enjoying the flora and fauna. Though we were looking for the tiger also, but let's see if we will be lucky this time or not. The park has some very tricky roads to drive on. Some roads were only, it was possible only through gypsy, the four-wheel drive, that you can enjoy these national parks. We see a lot of different varieties of reptiles, mammals, birds. This is around half an hour drive from Khajuraho. Khajuraho, many people go for its historical importance, for the lot of temples that are there. And Khajuraho has an airport also, so one can very easily go to Khajuraho from Delhi or Varanasi, and then from there one can just half an hour drive and one can reach to this beautiful national park. There are two gates in this national park. One is Madla Gate and another is Hinota Gate. So we went through the Madla Gate, and there are some lovely accommodations in this park, both private as well as Madhya Pradesh Tourism operated. We stayed in the Madhya Pradesh Tourism operated jungle cottages at Hinota. There are beautiful Swiss tents out there, and the food also was awesome. Though incidentally, the day on which we went to this beautiful national park, on that day the government of India announced the notbandi, so we had a bit of difficulty because we were cash strapped all of a sudden. But those problems on one side, the whole landscape was so beautiful that here we just stopped for a while and we went to see the deep gorge through which the river Ken was flowing. And as you can see in these beautiful Vindhyachal mountains, full of forest, and one can see deep below in the gorge the Ken river is flowing. There was a bit of every time we stepped out of the jeep in some areas where we were allowed by the guides accompanying us, we felt as if tiger is also tracking us. The Panna National Park is located in the Panna and Chhatarpur districts of Madhya Pradesh. It has an area of around 550 square kilometers, and in 1993 it was declared as a 22nd Tiger Reserve of India and the 5th in the Madhya Pradesh. It's a beautiful, I have been to like Kanha, Bandhavgarh and some other Tiger Reserves of Madhya Pradesh also. What I liked about this Tiger Reserve is it's a very varied geographical, you know, with mountains, rivers, gorges, grasslands, dense forests, everything you can encounter, and the drives were like amazing, like very adventurous. As the day was passing, it was getting hot and hot. We took two safaris out here, and there are some very nice private accommodations here also. One very famous one is Ken River Lodge and Panna Tiger Resort. So you have plenty of options to stay here, and at least two or three safaris I would recommend, that they are must if you have come to enjoy this beautiful park. There are many relics of Gondwana period also which are lying here and scattered all over the tiger park here. And the safari park, the timings were from sunrise till 11 a.m. in the morning hours, and then in the evening afternoon round was like 3 p.m. to sunset in the winter timings, like October to February. In the monsoons the park remains closed, it opens in October, and then in the summer season from March to June the morning timings are sunrise to 11 a.m. and the afternoon round starts from 4 p.m. to sunset. So I personally would recommend the morning safaris because there's a more chance of seeing the... Now we are in the area where there was a tiger sitting, and we saw the eye behind the bushes, and believe me, it was an amazing experience, amazing. We were there for around 3 hours, And we kept watching this beautiful tigress. Beautiful she was. Like the eyes, I can never forget the sight. And for 3 hours, she was sitting behind the bushes and we were here on the other side of the bush. And we waited that she walked or she come out and we can see her fully, but no, it was not possible. I still remember even after 5 years, her face was so captivating, so beautiful. Really, they are the king and queens of the jungles. After seeing the beautiful tigress, we again started our safari in the jungle and we kept on enjoying the beautiful landscapes, the deep gorges that are there. In monsoons, they must be like amazing sight. So deep. This is the Ken River flowing in the gorge. Nearby is one can also go to Ken Ghadiyal Sanctuary, which is not very far from this place and around an hour drive. Then one can also go to Panna Diamond Mines, the open diamond mines that are there in the Panna district. We also visited the fort in the Banda district, which comes in the Uttar Pradesh, and Kalinjar. It's a very, very old fort and very amazing on a hillock. Though it was around 5 to 6 hours drive from this place, from the Panna. But it was an amazing fort to see. We took 2 safaris here, both were around 4 hours duration. When you go in the early morning safaris, you should always be very well, you know, because the wind is very chilly. You always keep your caps and your goggles also, because as the sun climbs up, the weather becomes very hot out here. You should have plenty of water bottles with you. Maybe some light snacks if you can keep. Maybe like chocolates or those kind of things. But you should don't throw any garbage out in this beautiful place. See, like there are some roads on the hillocks, on the mountains, and with the valley on one side full of forests. It was an amazing experience, amazing. We should all try to preserve these wonders. These are wonders of nature. They should just be preserved at any cost. Now in the end, like we were, there were some drives on the banks of the River Ken. Here we saw a lot of crocodiles just, you know, taking sunbath on the banks of the river. This is the Ken, in the Ken Ghadiyal Sanctuary, where the Ghadiyals are artificially breeded also. This is an amazing place, volcanic eruptions, and these are the volcanic rocks, the deep gorges. There are around 5 to 6 colors of rocks out here. So we were like, you know, left with some amazing memories of this beautiful landscape in the north central India. Our day was, you know, coming to an end. We had enjoyed the park thoroughly. Then we came back to our place of stay in the Madhya Pradesh tourism Swiss camps. We had some time to relax out here. We enjoyed our food and then we had a very good night's sleep. In the morning we had some delicious breakfast. We enjoyed in the park. So refreshing to be in nature. Nature refreshes you like nothing else. We were very sad actually that we had to leave this beautiful place and now go back to the jungle, the city jungle, the concrete jungle. And we hope that we will come back to this amazing place again. Please do visit this place, enjoy the nature, protect the nature, love nature. It's like God. You see God. When you see nature, you actually see God. Thank you so much.